and sisters to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Praise be to Allah alone. We all praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, no one can show him guidance. May the best peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to a new edition of your program, Correct Your Citation. I would like also to welcome our studio guests, Sheikh Ismail, Khalid, Samir and Dino. Thank you so much for joining us. And as usual, we will begin by listening to a beautiful recitation for the verses which inshallah we'll try our best to learn their meanings and practice the recitation inshallah in the next segment, of course. So without any further ado, I kindly request Sheikh Ismail to go ahead and recite from the beginning of Surah Al-Mumtahana.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلنتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل يثقفوكم يكونوا لكم أعداء ويبسطوا إليكم أيديهم وألسنتهم بالسوء وودوا لو تكفرون لن تنفعكم أرحامكم ولا أولادكم يوم القيامة يفصل بينكم والله بما تعملون بصير قد كانت لكم أسوة حسنة في إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء منكم ومما تعبدون من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده إلا قول إبراهيم لأبيه لأستغفرن لك وما أملك لك من الله من شيء ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير.
بارك الله فيك، جزاك الله خيرا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة الممتحنة is a Madani surah, has been revealed in the Medina way after the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, approaching the conquest of Mecca. Its order in the Quran, it is chapter number 16, and it consists of 13 ayah. This is a very important and a magnificent surah, particularly the first ayah, which regulates the relationship between the believers and the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how the believers should treat the enemies of Allah, who are automatically their enemies as well. It happened to be the third chapter in the 28th part as well. We studied in the 28th part Surah Al-Mujadila and Surah Al-Hash. We finished that surah last time, alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah. And now we begin learning Surah Al-Mumtahana, and it is our routine to start with the word bank to learn some very important vocabulary. The first word we have today is the name of the surah itself, Al-Mumtahana. What does it mean? Number one, literally it means Al-Mumtahana, the woman to be tested. The woman to be tested. So because of the ta by the end of the word, it is feminine. And it is in the passive form. We had al-mujadila and al-mujadala. Al-mujadila in the active form, a woman who is arguing. Al-mumtahina, a woman who tests others. Al-mumtahana, the woman to be tested. And we will learn why this surah was named after this. It comes by the end of the surah, insha'Allah. So al-mumtahan is for masculine, the man to be tested. Al-mumtahana, the woman to be tested. The word awliya in the first ayah, la tattakhidu aduwi wa aduwakum awliya, is plural. A singular is wali. The wali is the ally, is the friend and the protector. Both. the upper hand and the lower hand. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes from his servants awliya, some of those whom he chooses, he protects, he gives them extra because they are near to him. And al-walaya from al-qurb or al-dunu, they are nearer to their awliya. المؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض. The believing men and women should be allies to one another, friends to one another, protectors to one another. And similarly, المنافقون والمنافقات بعضهم أولياء بعض. The hypocrites are allies to one another. That is their way. But it is more worthy with the believers to be أولياء. Okay. So أولياء is the plural of ولي, and ولي we learn its meaning. The next word is مودة. مودة is equivalent to love, affection, and compassion. Versus al-birr, which means to deal justly with, even with your enemies. That will be discussed in ayah number 8. أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم. But al-mawadda is al-mayl al-qalbi. Your heart goes for somebody. You love him. You have an affection towards that person or those kind of people. ابتغاء, we're still in the first ayah, the word ابتغاء means seeking. يبتغي, he seeks. تبتغي, she seeks. ابتغاء مرضاتي seeking what مرضاتي. That word also in the first ayah means my pleasure. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says ابتغاء مرضاتي seeking my pleasure. وابتغاء مرضاتي seeking my approval, consent and pleasure, which will require their word, of course. The next word is in the second ayah, ayah number 2. إِنْ يَثْقَفُوكُمْ يَثْقَفُوكُمْ, if they do gain power or dominance over you. يعني, if they overcome you, if they happen to have the upper hand over you, if they have a control over you, how will they treat you? We'll get to learn that, inshallah. Then, وَيَبْسُطُوا يَبْسُطُوا is to stretch out. That is in the second ayah as well. It says, وَيَبْسُطُوا إِلَيْكُمْ أَيْدِيَهُمْ وَأَلْسِنَتَهُمْ بِالسُّوءِ. So they will stretch forth, extend against you. Okay? Because of the context. The enemies, if they ever control or have power over your dominance, they will stretch forth their hands, their tongues, against you to harm you. Okay? لَإِنْ بَسَطْتَ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The story of Qabil and Habil in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Qabil said to his brother, if you ever stretch forth your hand to kill me, I will not do so. طيب. The word أَرْحَامُكُمْ or أَرْحَامَكُمْ, but in the ayah is أَرْحَامُكُمْ, which is in the subject form. Your relatives, your kinship will not benefit you. أولادكم, your sons. We have two more words quickly. The word بُرَآءُ in ayah number 4 means they disassociated themselves from them or free from their sin. البغضاء is hostility and hatred. Okay, now let's talk about the surah. And before we speak about the meaning, I would like to quote a hadith upon you that is collected by Imam Muslim. The narrator is the great companion Ali ibn Abi Talib. May Allah be pleased with him. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have sent me and Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam and Al-Miqdad, three great companions and great warriors and horsemen. He sent us to such and such place outside Al-Madinah, 12 miles outside Al-Madinah or so. And he said, there you will find a woman, a traveling woman, a rooster, and ask her to produce or to bring the document that she has, a message. She was bearing a message. From whom? From one of the companions. To whom? To the Meccan pagans. On the 8th year, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commanded by Allah to conquer Mecca. It was ready. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not announce the direction. He actually made a move to the opposite direction so that the news would not reach the Meccans. They don't have to prepare for a war and get ready. He wanted to surprise them with the attack to minimize the bloodshed. That was the main purpose. And that's why it was a peaceful conquer. He didn't want to kill anyone. The army of the Muslims were 10,000. They were capable, very much capable to eliminate all of them, to make a massacre. But the Prophet ﷺ did not want to do that. That's why he concealed his aim and the target and the journey to everybody. All the companions did not know where is he heading, even though some companions could assume that, but the Prophet ﷺ did not reveal that. One of those who figured out that the Prophet ﷺ is preparing to invade Mecca was Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a. May Allah be pleased with him. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a lived in Mecca, but he did not have a big family. He only had some relatives there, wife and children. But he did not have a big clan or tribe to look after them. So he thought, what if these guys try to take revenge from our families in Mecca? So he had this thought, if he sends a message, a warning signal to the Meccans that the Prophet ﷺ is approaching Mecca and he's planning to conquer Mecca, they may consider that and keep in mind that he has done them a favor, so they would not touch his family. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a, by the way, was one of the great companions. And he has attended the Battle of Badr. The 314 companions who attended the Battle of Badr, the Prophet ﷺ praised them and Allah admired them. And in the hadith, we will learn right now, what did the Prophet ﷺ say about Hatib and the people who attended the Battle of Badr, the 314 companions. So Ali and Miqdad and Zubayr followed the path that the Prophet ﷺ ordered them to do. And when they reached there, they found a woman. They got hold of her and said, take out the letter. She denied knowing anything. She said, I don't have anything. They said, you have to. So anyway, under pressure, she took out the message. Guess what? Where was she hiding the message? In her braids. She wrapped her hair around the message, the letter. So they took it out and they read it. A message from Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a to some of the Meccan chiefs to warn them that the Prophet ﷺ is about to invade Mecca. It's a serious trouble. So the Prophet ﷺ got hold of Hatib and he's teaching us the proper way of investigating before passing a judgment. You have to hear his excuse. So he said, why did you do that? In the presence of whom? Many companions and Umar ibn al-Khattab was attending. And I will let you figure out if Umar ibn Khattab was attending such investigation, how would he react? So Hatib admitted, yes, I did. Ya Rasulullah, by Allah, I am a believer. I certainly know that Allah will give you victory. I don't have any doubt. I have not changed. I have not upstated from the deen. But I only tried to do them a favor so that they would protect my family, would not hurt my family. But certainly I know that you'll be victorious and Allah will give you victory. So the case is closed, but I just wanted to protect my family. His short-sightedness led him to do so. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, da'ani aqta'u ra'sah. Let me chop off his head. I have to kill him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, Ya Umar. Wama adraak. أن الله اطلع على أهل بدر فقال افعلوا ما شئتم فقد غفرت لكم. Don't you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has looked at the companions who attended the battle of Badr and said, do as you wish, I have forgiven all your sins. He's one of those who attended Badr. He's one of those whom Allah is pleased with them. In addition to, he had an excuse, even though from our point of view is invalid. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood that he was truthful and he's sincere. So he blamed him for that and he has had him free. So the ayah was revealed in order to explain to us what is the nature of our relationship with the enemies of Allah. Who are the enemies of Allah? Are they everybody who does not believe in Allah and in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Should we wage a war against every person who does not say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah? Look at this ayah, how it explains that. Who is the enemy? And then in ayah number 8 and ayah number 9, which confirms that there may be some kuffar, disbelievers. But Allah orders you to treat them kindly and with justice. Why? Because they did not wage a war against you. They did not target you because of your religion. They did not force you out of your homes. They did not oppress the believers, but only those who wage a war against Muslims or challenge Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the enemies of Allah, and accordingly they are also your enemies. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا عَدُوِّي وَعَدُوَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءَ تُلْقُونَ إِلَيْهِمْ بِالْمَوَدَّةِ وَقَدْ كَفَرُوا بِمَا جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ الْحَقِّ يُخْرِجُونَ الرَّسُولَ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Let's stop right there. Even though you see the sign لا, which means when you read, you shouldn't stop here. And if you stop, you should go back to read before until you provide a complete meaning. But in the course of giving the tafsir, I just would like to explain the general meaning. All you who believe, Allah is calling on the true believers. So those who hear the command and respond are المؤمنين حق, the true believers. لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء. Take not my enemy and your enemy as awliya, plural of wali, as allies and protectors. How could any wise person trust his enemy to be his protector? How could any sane person trust his enemy to be his guardian, to wish him well? He is an enemy. تُلْقُونَ إِلَيْهِمْ بِالْمَوَدَّةِ. You show love and compassion to them and friendship. وَقَدْ كَفَرُوا بِمَا جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. While, on the other hand, those enemies have disbelieved in the truth which has come to you. Not only that, they exceeded the limit. يُخْرِجُونَ الرَّسُولَ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. They had driven out the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and you yourselves. You are amongst al-muhajirin. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a was a muhajir. Have you forgotten why did you make hijrah? Have you forgotten who drove you out of Mecca? Out of the most sacred place on earth? It was the Meccans because of their torture and persecution to the Muslims. صح. So how can you take them as allies? How can you take them as awliya? While you disbelieved in the truth and they force you out of your homes, أَن تُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ رَبِّكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ خَرَجْتُمْ جِهَادًا فِي سَبِيلِ وَابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ. In order to provide you with the complete meaning, they say, لا, do not stop here, which means, why did they force you out of Mecca? Why did they drive you out of your homes? For one simple reason. Because they disbelieved in Allah, in the Quran, and in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they did so because, on the other hand, تؤمنوا بالله ربكم, because you did believe in Allah, your Lord. So, إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي. How could you do that? It doesn't match the good intention if you're going out, if you're marching forth, if you come forth in order to strive for my sake and seeking my pleasure. Allah is saying, you're doing this all, you're going to Mecca to conquer Mecca, all of that for my sake, right? To free it from the idols and spread the deen. How could you compromise? How could you say that I'm going out for the sake of Allah and seeking the pleasure of Allah? Meanwhile, on the other hand, you're taking the enemies of Allah as your intimate friends, as your protectors and best companions. You exchange love with them? No, it's not exchange. You show love and they show hostility. سبحان الله. تسرون إليهم بالمودة. Secretly, you show friendship and love to them. Like the message that Hatib had sent secretly. Who told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about Hatib's attempt? How did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم knew? He did not have a CIA. He did not have any intelligent system or informations. He did not have spies. But he had Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would inform him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to see from behind the same as if he were to see in front of him. Because he's a prophet and Allah gave him this power. Meanwhile, he was still a human being. Remember, Ghazwat Bani Nadir. Why did it happen? Because they tried to assassinate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did he know? How did he figure out? Jibreel alayhi wa sallam came to him. So likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about this attempt of Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a. Not only that, he said to Ali, Al-Zubayr and Al-Muqdad, exactly in this place you will find a woman, capture her and get the message from her. He located her without GPS because he had the wahi with him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you're doing that in secret. وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا أَخْفَيْتُمْ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ. And I know best about what? What you have concealed and what you have revealed. And I love this. I love the eloquence of the Quran. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says, I know best about what? Not what you have revealed and concealed. No, he began with the difficult one. With what you have concealed. What you've done behind closed doors. وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ. This guy who came to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he was paid in Mecca. In Mecca. When he arrived and he poisoned his dragon in poison, and he did in poison for so long to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "What brought you here?" He said, "I came to ransom my son." He said, "No, you lied. Didn't you sit and so and so and such and such around the Kaaba? And he said, I will take care of your family. I will support them after whatever happens to you happen. If you assassinate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. I bear witness you are truly the messenger of Allah. By Allah, I was sitting there and no one else was sitting with us. How did you know that? وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا أَخْفَيْتُمْ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْهُ مِنْكُمْ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ إِنْ يَثْقَفُوكُمْ Whoever does so has went astray, a great deal. إِنْ يَثْقَفُوكُمْ يَكُونُ لَكُمْ أَعْدَاءَ These guys whom the enemies of Allah and your enemies, if they ever take dominance over you, they will show hostility to you and they will be very stern against you. And they will stretch out their hands and tongues against you to harm you. وَوَدُّوا لَوْ تَكْفُرُونَ They would love that they turn, you would turn kuffar. You know, November 17th, 2004, the New York Times published an article about a Yemeni guy who's living in New York. This guy, his name is Al-Ansi, after the guy who claimed the prophethood, Al-Aswad Al-Ansi. This guy did something very evil. This guy was an FBI informant to spy against Muslims. He traveled all the way to Yemen to set up a Muslim clerk, a Muslim scholar. And for a reason or another, he managed to convince him to travel with him to Germany. And there, they set him up, and the CIA and so on, they captured him and extradited him to the States. And they made a case, and they give him a life sentence or whatever. This guy is free now because the whole case has collapsed. How did it collapse? This guy who's 50 years old, who's living in the States, the Ansi Yemeni guy, have accepted to be an informant, and he set up many Muslims before this incident for one thing, to give him a U.S. citizenship and to bring his family to the States. They made a deal. He set up many people, and the last was this guy. But they did not give him the citizenship, and all what he collected is $100,000. So, he wanted to object and protest that because the FBI never fulfilled their promise with him. He sat himself on a fire in front of the White House. I give you the date of the article. I was there when this happened, November 17th, 2004. And the article is still there, explains in details. لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق. We ran out of time. Inshallah, we'll continue next time. But at least take a short break and we'll continue in a couple of minutes. Stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Ask Hoda.
If you're still in Mecca or close by to Mecca, then you have to know that you are still in the state of Ihram. As long as it is not for sale, then he does not have to pay zakah for it. Forbade praying witr, similar to Maghrib prayer. So whoever prays witr three rak'ahs and sitting after the second rak'ah as if he's praying Maghrib prayer, this is forbidden, this is haram. Euthanasia is permissible with animals, but not with human beings. If an animal is suffering, killing an animal for a legitimate reason is permissible. Both are acceptable, but the majority say that after the rukur is the place of qunut. But both was reported.
Have a question or concern on your mind? Hoda TV decided, based on popular demand, we will be bringing you an additional episode of Ask Hoda, with Sheikh Azim bin Luqman al-Hakim, live from Jeddah, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, narrated that when Allah, glory be to him, wishes good for someone, he bestows upon him understanding of the religion, and that Allah makes the path to paradise easy for those who seek knowledge. Preoccupied by work or family in the modern world, a Muslim may struggle to find time for acquiring Islamic knowledge. To ease this struggle, we are launching Hoda Academy to be your gateway to online Islamic e-learning.
Enroll now and study from our renowned scholars. Learn Aqeedah from Dr. Muhammad Salah.
Learn fiqh from Dr. Hatim Al-Hajj.
Learn hadith from Dr. Muhammad Saeed.
Learn tafsir from Sheikh Ibrahim Zidane.
And learn Arabic from our professional instructors.
Successful graduates of Hoda Academy will go through a final test and eventually receive a certificate of completion.
To enroll and learn more about Hoda Academy, please visit us online at hodaonlineacademy.com.
Hoda Academy, your gateway to authentic Islamic knowledge.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. Our phone numbers beginning with area code 002-0238-555-248-249, and the email address is tajweed@huda.tv. All of that should appear on the screen for your convenience, inshallah. Okay. Our first caller is Amir from United Arab Emirates. Assalamu alaikum, Amir, and welcome to the program.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sheikh.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
Go ahead and recite from the beginning of Surah Al-Mumtahana.
Inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلنتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل.
حسبك يا عامر, and follow up the correction please. Okay, first of all, in the word لا تتخذوا, you should not exceed the natural mad to harakas. You should not say لا تتخذوا because it's not even followed by Hamza. So لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء. There is a connected مد. مد متصل because the مد letter is followed by Hamza in the same word. So if you stretch it to five, fine. But you did not do any مد at all. So لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة. There is إخفاء. إليهم بالمودة. That's called إخفاء شفوي. Also in the case of the إخفاء, which is called إخفاء حقيقي because the non-vowel noon is followed by the calf, such as in كنتم, there is a غنّة, two counts. You have to observe that. Also in the word وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ, there is no مد there. You see the zero on top of the alif would cancel the alif. It will be stated in writing, but it will not be read. And that's why you will snatch it. You will say وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ, وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ. Remember, if that was a mad letter, guess what? It is followed by Hamza. So that would be a mad munfasil. So the least I would say, وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ. But of course, this is not true. Or you can stretch it up to four if you apply the mad. But this is not a mad letter though. So you recite it with a mere fatha or zabr on top of the noon. You say, وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا أخفى أَخْفَيْتُمْ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ. Okay, then the tanween of the idgham with the ghunna. I'm sorry, the ghunna in the case of the noon followed by the ya. The ghunna two counts. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْهُ مِنْكُمْ, there is ikhfa, مِنْكُمْ, noon followed by the kaf. فَقَدْ ضَلَّ سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ. بارك الله فيك, جزاك الله خيرا. حبيبة from Nigeria, السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Okay, go ahead and recite from the beginning again, please.
بسم الله, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي.
جهادا في سبيلي, that is إخفاء حقيقي. جهادا في سبيلي
وابتغاء مرضاتي. تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلنتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل. إن يسقطوكم يكونوا لكم أعداء ويبسطوا إليكم أيديهم وألسنتهم بالسوء وودوا لو تكفرون. لن تنفعكم أرحامكم ولا أولادكم يوم القيامة يفصل بينكم والله بما تعملون بصير.
حسبك يا حبيبة. Thank you so much. Very good, mashallah. Ali from United Arab Emirates. Assalamu alaikum, يا علي.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We're going to recite back from the beginning, please.
Inshallah, Sheikh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول
يخرجون
الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلنتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل.
حسبك يا علي. Wait on the online, please. Do not hang up. We want to clarify the tahqiq or the verification of certain letters. Sometimes this is a common error. People do not realize that they skipped a letter. They think, I read it. Yeah, you read it, but not clear enough to be heard. Listen to this. وَبِتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ I think I read the Hamza, but I didn't. You have to verify. So you say, وَبِتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ Okay, then.
وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا أَخْفَيْتُمْ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُمْ
Hamza has to be heard. It's not sufficient to say, yeah, I read it. It has to be heard as well. Okay? Continue, please, if you're still there. Okay? Assume that you're offline. You're not on the line anymore. We have Sister Huda from United Arab Emirates. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the program.
Wa alaikum salam.
Okay. I'd like to hear Surah Al-Mumtahana from the beginning again, please.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم وعدوكم أولياء تلقون
يا هدى هدى Do you know Arabic?
No.
Okay. Let me explain something very interesting to you. The recitation is magnificent and I would like for you to continue reading. Okay? But now when I stop at the word لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم which means do not take my enemy and your enemy. Then I stop. I want to begin. I cannot say وعدوكم أولياء because what happened is I actually converted the meaning. I provided the opposite meaning of what Allah wants to deliver. He said that, and your enemies are protectors. When you say وَعَدُوَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاء, that literally means your enemies should be your protectors, should be your allies. So what do you say? I can say, if I run out of breath, I say, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا عَدُوِّي وَعَدُوَّكُمْ And I run out of breath. I go back and I say, لَا تَتَّخِذُوا عَدُوِّي وَعَدُوَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءَ تُلْقُونَ Then I can say, تُلْقُونَ إِلَيْهِمْ بِالْمَوَدَّةِ Continue, please. Bring it from the beginning.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا عَدُوِّي وَعَدُوَّكُمْ لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة وقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي
Are you there? We may have lost Sister Huda. Please try again. Okay, we have Nasser from Oman. Assalamu alaikum, Nasser.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I thought you would have to wait for a little longer, but subhanallah. Okay, go ahead and continue. But why don't you read from the beginning again, please? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم
وعدوكم أنا قلت له the difference after he finished
وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة فقد كفروا بما جاءكم من الحق
يخرجون الرسول وإياكم أن تؤمنوا بالله ربكم إن كنتم خرجتم جهادا في سبيلي وابتغاء مرضاتي تسرون إليهم بالمودة وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم وما أعلمتم ومن يفعله منكم فقد ضل سواء السبيل إن يسألوكم يكونوا لكم أعداء ويبسطوا إليكم أيديهم وألسنتهم بالسوء بودوا لو تكفروا
لن تنفعكم
أرحامكم ولا أولادكم يوم القيامة يفصل بينكم والله بما تعملون بصير.
حسبك جزاك الله خيرا. I wish I had time to explain the difference between وعدوكم and عدوكم, but we ran out of time. And inshallah Azza Jal, hopefully we'll get to meet next time by the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And until then, I leave you in the care of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.